This episode of Sexplanations is sponsored by Adam and Eve.
Oh, so cute!
I'm Dr. Lindsay Doe. I'm a clinical sexologist and host of the sex curious show, Sexplanations. I like to be educated. I thought it might be helpful to know what it feels like to go through a menstrual cycle, not just what's happening inside the body. To do this, I did a lot of research, spoke with people who know more than I do on the subject, and mapped out everything I learned all pretty like. Keep in mind, this does not apply to everyone. Some people are on hormones, birth control, age, body mass and fat, genetics, diet, exercise, sleep, breastfeeding, behaviors like smoking, drinking, traveling, health conditions like PCOS, which I have a video on, and thyroid disorders influence how a person's unique body will experience menstrual cycles, if at all. And by menstrual cycle, I mean all the phases, the whole cycle, not just menstruation when you're bleeding. There's 350 to 500 of these in a person's lifetime. The first one is called menarche. The last is called anarchy. Just kidding. It's called menopause. A typical menstrual cycle is 21 to 35 days long. This video is timed around an average 28-day cycle. The starting point of the cycle, or day one, is blood. Which makes sense. It's like the flag that says, and go. How does that feel? Maybe there's some relief that you're less likely to be pregnant or that all the heaviness will dissipate soon. But for most, this day doesn't feel great. A 2012 study published in the Journal of Pain Research found that 84% of those who menstruate experience dysmenorrhea, painful periods. 15 to 25% to the degree that they can't engage in their day-to-day lives because the symptoms are so severe. That's sore breasts, achiness in the muscles and joints, abdominal cramps, like excruciating towel-wringing cramps, uncomfortable bloating, fatigue, there's lower back pain, like a rod getting shoved into the spine, and for some, pain in the thighs. More than two-thirds of people experience catamenial gastrointestinal symptoms, the clinical term for period poop, which entails going from being all blocked up and constipated before your period to diarrhea. And then there's acne and trouble sleeping, maybe telogen effluvium, in which the sudden drop of estrogen causes hair loss. And finally, clumpy, brownish, and bright red endometrium flowing out of the crotch with no valve to control when or for how long. I get emotional, wanting to be cuddled and cared for, reassured that my relationship survived the previous week, which we'll get into. Other people on the more extreme end experience migraines, collapsed lungs, and seizures. Ah, reproduction, you big jerk. So that's bleeding. When that ends, around day six, there's typically an improvement in mood. Energy increases, confidence boosts, productivity is up. For the next week leading up to ovulation, called the follicular phase, I feel really creative and I want to do all the projects. Some call it their spring. That's approximately days 6 to 13, basically the best we feel all cycle. The body is full, take on the world. Sunshine and flowers, blooming, get shit done, find a mate, build a nest in the womb for a potential pregnancy, if you're into that kind of thing. Stress is easier to cope with, change is easier to adapt to, there's more clarity, capacity, and motivation for life plans. Verbal skills, coordination, pain tolerance, imagination, memory, focus, and self-efficacy are at their peaks. You like people, the world is manageable, you know who you are, and you have a sense of launching, which actually makes the follicular phase a perfect time to try new things. You can ask for a raise then, push yourself physically, get out there socially, and do all the playing. The closer you get to ovulation, approximately day 14 or later, the longer your cycle is, the more sexual changes you'll notice. The voice gets higher, suggesting fertility. One's walk is sexier with more swing in the hips. Some research even suggests that there's a shift in facial bone structure. The cervix is softer and rises up away from the vaginal opening so that it's less prone to being slammed by objects of insertion. Orgasm intensity is at its highest level. What a week! Just keep in mind that for the rest of the cycle following this, you will likely not feel the same. Scheduling dinner parties, clothes swaps, outdoor adventures, double dates, etc. for the weeks to come is a good way to destroy your future self. From day 13-14, when I'm ovulating through the second half of my cycle, I feel very different than the first half. 60% of people experience ovulation really positively. They feel attractive, sexy, and alive. Their posture is mwah. They dress themselves to the nines, they have pep in their step, gorgeous glowing complexions. Sensuality is va-va-voom. You're pretty much the most radiant and eloquent version of yourself, which makes sense evolutionarily. because this is your one time per month to attract a reproductive mate. Jeffrey Miller and colleagues' study of erotic dancers found that tips for lap dancers were 29% higher during the 24 to 48 hours of ovulation than the weeks after ovulation, and that they were 81% higher during ovulation than the lap dances during menstruation. If ovulation was like this for me, I'd try to shoot every episode of Sexplanations on that egg-laying day. Pretty Lindsay with a sharp mind exuding sexual prowess. Why not? Unfortunately, for 40% of us, ovulation is almost the antithesis of rejuvenation. These amazing things might be happening to our brains and bodies, but it's hard to notice because it feels like a tiny dinosaur is clawing its way out of my ovary. Middleschmerz, meaning middle pain, is thought to be caused by the ovary's surface stretching to release that follicle with a mature egg inside, and or from an allergy to the fluid that leaks out when the follicle ruptures. Symptoms can include dull, cramp-like, or sharp and sudden pain that's usually mild, but in rare cases can be more severe. It usually lasts a few minutes to a few hours, but may last as long as a day or two, says the Mayo Clinic. The first time I noticed it, I took myself to the ER thinking that I had appendicitis. I hate it. Do I wish that I was in a short skirt, feeling myself, picking up dudes, chicks, and gender-free hotties? Yes. Instead, it's sweats and isolation with no thought of sex except the curiosity about why sex is so repulsive to me when I'm actually fertile. What's that evolutionary function, nature? At least it passes. Next is the luteal phase. This is after ovulation until bleeding starts again. It's when people are the most detail-oriented and critical. Because of the increase in progesterone, which you'll need 10% more calories to fuel, your mind and body aren't buzzing as much. Flirty you comes down from the fertility pageant and starts to chill out. Around days 15, 16, 17, your personality is pretty close to average, no high highs and not yet the low lows, but still a little back and forth in your thinking. Wait until days 18 to 22 to make any big decisions if you want the best long-term results. According to hormonology.com, the end of week 3 is the reality check. This is when the critical mind is most alert, but not yet pissed off. Note, this time frame is an estimation. It's powerful to track your own hormones and sync your lifestyle, work, diet, physical activity, etc., to your cycle. This is especially true as we approach menstruation around week 4, because 75% of us who go through all of this experience premenstrual syndrome. Bloating, breast pain, body aches, swollen hands and feet, depression, anxiety, trouble focusing and getting along with humans, mood swings, crying spells, irritability, anger, and confusion. Dr. Lisa Watson lists 133 changes correlated with the luteal phase shifts in hormones. Hormones are powerful, but you can work with them. If I'm tracking, I know with some certainty that I'm going to be grouchy or bitchy during the week before my period. One theory is that this cat-like hostility helps to dissolve any relationships that were supposed to get me pregnant but didn't. So my ovaries push everyone away to find someone who will do a better job next time. It's hard to explain to one's organs that you're pan, asexual, single, not wanting kids for whatever reason, and that the world isn't actually against you when you don't conceive. To mitigate the damage, I can warn people around me I'm luteal. Prepare berry tea for myself, eat pre-made nutritional feel-good meals, and bathe in sitcoms. And I can avoid scheduling things that will make my symptoms worse, like waxing, new tattoos, and sadomasochism. My pain tolerance is down. There are all sorts of suggestions on social media, entire communities dedicated to cycle syncing so that food and physical activity match the body's needs and abilities. This is especially crucial for those who suffer from severe symptoms that make it difficult to function. Premenstrual dysphoric disorder affects 8% of the general population, but rates are much higher among people who are neurodivergent. Look out for each other and your bodies. Blood will come again, most likely, and it will start all over. Stay curious.
This episode of Sexplanations is sponsored by adamandeve.com. Do you see what they sent me? These are official cherry emoji vibrator and official eggplant emoji vibrator. Body safe sexual wellness. Oh, how cute! Oh, and the packaging. Look at this. A sweet little pouch. I'm such a sucker for stuff like this. You have the charging cable and this tiny little cherry. Oh! So cute! It lights up. So I've talked about dangling toys before. This is wonderful because you're not really controlling the direct position of it. There's a little bit of a detachment. It's like a stranger, you know, when you sit on your hand and you cut off the nerve flow and then you just use your hand like it's a stranger because you can't feel. It's the same thing. This little wiggle here is so cool. So powerful. Let's look at the eggplant. Gorgeous box. Information, 10 vibration patterns, water resistant, USB charge cable included for its battery charging, goes for 50 minutes, charges for 90. It's made out of medical grade silicone and has a 1-year warranty. Hello, gorgeous. Oh, this is the kind of thing to carry around in your fanny pack. Look at that, it's so gorgeous. You're not charged out of the box, but you are gorgeous and I can imagine what you're like. So soft. And it comes with a pouch, so all my dog fur doesn't get on this gorgeous medical grade silicone emoji vibrator. It's a full meal. If you want to get one of these for yourself or friend or all of your family members, go to adamandeve.com, use the promo code DOE to get 50% off an eligible item and free shipping on your entire order to the US and Canada.
Patamenial gastrointestinal symptoms, the clinical term for period poop. Pretty much the most radiant out of the little... Pretty Lindsay with a sharp sense of humor. What? I'm making shit up. Hey, kombucha. Ow, 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 ow. How do you make yourself burp? There we go. Okay.